Hello everyone, welcome to Noma Today. My name is Noma and I'm really glad to be here. Thank you so much to every single person that has subscribed, for every like, for every comment, for all the love. I received it and I'm very grateful. So guys, Valentine is sort of in the air and I felt like, you know, I should talk about love. I mean, it's always time to talk about love, but for this video particularly, I just felt, you know, it would be in keeping with the vibe or in keeping with the atmosphere. In this video, I want to talk about five signs that he's not the one. Now, when I talk about signs that he's not the one, I mean like red flags in a relationship that you'll see, which will, you know, make you pause, or which should make you pause and think and reevaluate and ask yourself, is there any need advancing, or should I just, you know, count my loss and cut out? Without wasting too much time, let's jump into it. Now, the first sign that I'm going to talk about is if you do not like him. It sounds like a no-brainer. Who would go into a relationship without really liking the person? But it does happen for various reasons. So when I say, do you like him? I mean, do you like his company? Do you enjoy his company? Do you enjoy the conversations you have? Do you like the way he thinks? Do you have fun with him? You know, let this not be mistaken with liking his money, his position and influence. And if those things are present in your relationship, they're great things, but that is not enough for your relationship to ride on. You need something much deeper, something that will not change. Position, influence, money comes and goes, but the core of a person, who they are, you know, will rarely ever change. So you need to find out, do I like him? You will need that reserve in your relationship, because there will be rocky parts of a relationship, surely there will be, but having this reserve to draw from will help you to ride through those rocky aspects of your relationship. Also, it's important for you to know, does he like me? Does he enjoy your company? Does he see you? Does he recognize those unique things about you? Does he appreciate them? You also need to find out, am I trying to force myself onto him? Am I trying to manipulate myself into his life? And the easiest example that I can think of is when you try to hold a man down, maybe with pregnancy. The effect of this, I feel, has a short lifespan, and then when it runs out, you'll find out that you're left in a relationship with somebody who begins to resent you, or begins to, you know, becomes indifferent, behaves like he's in the relationship only because he has to be there. One is if you have to lie about who you are, pretend to be what you are not, you know, misrepresent yourself upward or downward. You know, for example, you find out that he likes a certain kind, you know, some men make it known that they like certain kinds of ladies, to dress a certain way, to look a certain way, and then you know that that's just not in keeping with your character or your style, but you go all the way, you don't mind spending money that you don't have, buying things that you can't afford, just to kind of meet up with that standard. And you find out that you start acting different, maybe you're talking differently, you know, just to fit in with his picture. And I'm not saying that you shouldn't try to, you know, be the best person you are whenever you're with somebody that you are in a relationship with, but what I'm saying is that when you begin to act, when you're like in a movie, you need to ask yourself, how long is this movie going to last for? Am I going to perpetually, you know, be acting? Do I have the capacity to continue? Also, when you feel the need to deem yourself in order to appear a certain way, for example, you're with somebody who is a traditional man and he likes women to be a certain way, he believes that women should be seen and not heard, but you're an outspoken person, you have opinions, you have ideas, you want to make contributions, but in order to seem like wife material, you deem yourself, you dull yourself down, you keep your mouth quiet, and you appear meek. But how long are you going to continue with that trend? Is it something that you can keep up with for the rest of your life? Because of course we all know that marriage is not something that you just go into and come out of. It's a lifetime journey. The second sign that he is not the one is if you do not have common values. Now, in my last video, I did say that you should expect that there will be disagreements. It's just a common thing in relationships. You will not always agree. But it's important to note that, you know, not for fundamental things. You have to agree on certain things, things that are at the core of who you are, you know, things that matter to you. Both of you should agree. So, for example, you know how you feel about lying and stealing, advance free fraud, for example, maybe visiting Jasmine, and you need to find out, do you people agree on things like that? Because you don't want going forward in the future to find out that one day he says, okay, I want to buy Expo for Wyatt for my child, because after all, my parents bought Expo for me, and then it's something that you absolutely don't believe in. So it's important to know that you people believe in the same things, and if you find out that the lines are parallel and that they will never meet, then there's no need for you to continue. The third sign that he's not the one is if he does not respect women. You're with someone and it's very clear by his statements and by his treatment of women around him that he does not respect women. The waitress in a restaurant, the lady or the woman driving in her car on the street, the women around you, he always has vulgar or demeaning things to say about them. He doesn't believe that a woman can have anything to contribute to anything. And then you hear him say it repeatedly. You hear him say things like, you know, say women, know they get sense. You hear him say that, oh, my father told me that we shouldn't let women know what we're doing. He treats women like subhuman, and you're there, and for some reason you feel like you're special. He's going to treat you differently. My dear, what exactly is it that's making you feel that you're so special? It's just a matter of time before that bug turns around and bites you. So it's something that you need to think about seriously now and know, can I do this for the long haul? Can I put up with this for the long haul? The next sign that he's not the one is if there are many unanswered questions. There are many unanswered questions. You don't know what he does for a living. You don't know how he makes his money. You don't know where he's been for the past 5 years. You don't know and you don't care to know. I believe that different questions should be asked. I'm not saying that you should know every single detail of his life, you know, from the past, but there are major things that you need to be able to answer to. Your answer to those things should not be, I don't know. No, you should find out. And if there's anything questionable about his past, you need to know about it, because sometimes very sad to notice that women get into relationships with men who clearly have a bad past that they have not dealt with. You know, he has a history of violence, he has a history of being unfaithful, his past relationships, his hard stories, or while you're with him, you're noticing that people are coming every day to ask, oh, why haven't you paid me this money? You've been owing me for 6 months. You see it happen 3 or 4 times. There's really no point in inserting yourself in that kind of toxicity. I mean, it's obvious to you, it's clear to you, why remain there? Also, if he is possessive or authoritative, and I've noticed that a good number of women seem to find it flattering when there are people that are possessive. People, for example, who say, oh, I don't want you talking to other men, or I don't want you to work because I don't want men to hit on you. You know, you kind of find it flattering. You feel that he wants you all to himself, or you find it flattering that he has rules on how you dress, he has rules for how you talk or who you should talk to, your friends, where you should go to. And you it kind of, you know, tickles you, and in my opinion, that is just a sign of something much deeper. It's a sign that this person has control issues, might have self-esteem issues, and these things will have a much bigger effect in your relationship going forward. You have rules for everything and you don't realize that, you know what, I'm kind of in a prison, and this prison is only going to get smaller by the time I become married to this person. This is a sign that I feel that you should not tolerate on any level. If you find out that this is how it is at the beginning of your relationship, there's no reason to think that, oh, it's going to change. I think you should just cut your losses and find your way out. If you have watched up to this point, thank you very much. I saved my most important point for last, and that is he must be God-fearing. I did have a problem. I hesitated sort of to say God-fearing because God-fearing is a word that I feel has been abused over time. It's been abused and misused. I feel like a lot of ladies feel that if God-fearing is not on your list of attributes of a man that you want to be with, then priorities are misplaced, or that maybe you want to just, you know, marry a bad man. And I think for that reason, people just put God-fearing without actually thinking about what it means. I will define a God-fearing man as a man who is submitted to the authority of God in his action, in his words, the principles by which he lives his life. And I feel that when you have that sort of person, it kind of deals with a large percentage of your problem, because this person will rarely ever hurt you, you know, knowingly. And even when he does hurt you, because God has access to his heart, he quickly recovers. You just don't see him going off misbehaving long term. And I think it's very important to have, because you need somebody who, more than trying to please you, is trying to please God. Now, note that I didn't say that the person is a church goer, or is the deacon in your church, or maybe the leader of a group, because it's become obvious to us more so recently that those are not indicators of whether a person is submitted to the authority of God. Now, you have to be observant and you have to be sensitive. You cannot just relegate your brain, you know, you can't just say, oh, because he's in church, then he's good enough for me. And a lot of women have made that mistake, because they met someone in church, you just feel like, okay, it's fine, he's good enough for me, and they've been disappointed. Because you have to be sensitive, you have to be observant, you have to use your brain, you have to do your due diligence. And if you fail to do so, you cannot blame anybody for the consequences when they come. So that's my last point. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have, please click on the like button. If you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe. I enjoy reading your comments. I want to respond to your comments, so please comment and hit the notification bell so that you get notified when I release my next video. Thank you very much, and until my next one.